Hello everyone, this is Payal Bacha. Welcome to Pharma Desert. In this video, we will discuss about quality control, analytical method, transfer, and qualification as well as validation. So let's get started. These are the list of contents we will discuss in this video. First one is quality control, analytical method transfer. Second one is possible experimental designs and acceptance criteria for analytical testing. Next one is qualification and validation. In qualification and validation, general qualification of facility and equipment, analytical methods validation, manufacturing process validation, packaging, and last one is cleaning validation. First one, quality control, analytical method transfer. Transfer of analytical methods should accommodate all the analytical testing required to demonstrate compliance of the product to be transferred with the registered specifications. That means transfer of analytical methods, which should accommodate all the analytical testing that are required to demonstrate compliance of product, it should be transferred with registered specification. Transfer of analytical methods used to test pharmaceutical products, their ingredients and cleaning samples needs to be in place before process validation studies of manufacturing operations can be carried out. That means transfer of analytical methods used to test pharmaceutical products, their ingredients, cleaning samples, they are needs to be in place before process validation studies of manufacturing operations it should be carried out. So what is the quality control for analytical method transfer? First one is transfer of analytical method which should accommodate all the analytical testing they are required to demonstrate compliance of the product that should be transferred with register specification, and transfer of analytical method that are particularly used to test any pharmaceutical product as well as their excipient and cleaning sample or any residue sample, they needs to be placed before process validation studies of manufacturing operations can be carried out. Next one is analytical methods used to test pharmaceutical products, starting materials, packaging components, cleaning residue, samples, if applicable, should be implemented at the testing laboratory before testing of sample for process validation studies is performed by receiving unit. So almost same second point as well as third point. In this point, analytical methods that are particularly used to test any pharmaceutical product as well as starting material, packaging component and cleaning samples, if applicable, all are implemented at the testing laboratory before testing of sample for process validation studies it is performed by receiving unit, and process validation samples may be tested at the receiving unit and the sending unit or a third laboratory. So process validation sample that may be tested at receiving unit, sending unit or any third laboratory. A protocol, technology transfer protocol, which defining the steps should be prepared for transfer of analytical methods. And the analytical methods Transfer protocol should include a description of objective, scope, and responsibility of sending unit and receiving unit, a specification of materials and methods. The experimental design and acceptance criteria, as well as documentation, procedure for handling of deviations, references, signed approval, and details of reference samples. So, a protocol which defines steps, it should be prepared for transfer of analytical method. So, which type of steps are prepared for transfer of analytical methods? The analytical methods transfer protocol, it should include description of objectives as well as scope of technology transfer, responsibility of sending unit and receiving unit, specification of materials and methods, as well as experimental design and its acceptance criteria, documentations, which type of documentations, including information to be supplied with the result and report, forms to be used, if anyone, as well as procedure for handling of deviations, references, signed approval, and details of reference samples like starting materials, intermediates, as well as finished product. So all are the analytical method transfer protocol. The sending unit SU, which indicate sending unit, and RU, which indicate receiving unit. SU, responsibility for the transfer of analytical methods, R2, that means the sending unit's responsibilities for transfer of analytical methods. First one is, which provide method specific training for analyst and other quality control staff if required. Next one is, assist in analysis of quality control testing result. Next one, define all methods to be transferred for testing a given product, starting material, or cleaning sample. So, sending unit responsibility for transfer of analytical methods are follow. First one is, sending unit responsibility are that provide method specific training for analyst and other quality control staff if required. That means, sending unit which provide method specific training for analyst as well as other quality control staff if required. Second one is, sending unit also assist in analysis of quality control testing results. And last one is, sending unit which define all the methods it should be transferred for testing a given product, starting material, or cleaning sample. Define experimental design, sampling methods, as well as acceptance criteria. So all are the sending unit's responsibility. Next one is, sending unit also provide any validation reports for method under transfer and demonstrate their robustness. So sending unit provide validation report. Sending unit provide validation reports for method under transfer as well as it demonstrate their robustness. Robustness, what is robustness? That means the quality or a condition of being strong or and in good condition. That means robustness that indicate quality or condition of being strong and in good condition. Next one is, it provide details of equipment used as necessary and any standard reference samples. So sending unit provide details of equipment that are already used as necessary, and it also provide standard reference samples. Next one is, sending unit also provide approved procedures used in testing and review and approve transfer report. So sending unit which provide approved procedures that are used in testing and review and approve transfer report. So what was the responsibility of sending unit? First one is, they define experimental design, sampling method and acceptance criteria. Second one is, they provide validation report for method under transfer and it demonstrate their robustness. Next one is, sending unit also provide details of equipment that are used if necessary and any standard reference samples. And last one is, they provide approved procedure that are used in testing and review and approved transfer reports. What was the responsibility of receiving unit? Second one is, receiving unit responsibilities. First one is, review analytical methods that are provided by sending unit and formally agree on acceptance criteria before execution of the transfer protocol. So what was the responsibilities? So receiving unit's responsibilities are follow. First one, receiving unit which review analytical methods that are already provided by sending unit. After reviewing, receiving unit formally agree on acceptance criteria before execution of transfer protocol. Second one is, receiving unit which ensure that the necessary equipment for quality control is available and qualified at receiving unit site. That means receiving unit ensure that any necessary equipment for quality control, that means any equipment that is required for quality control and qualified at receiving unit site. After that, equipment used by receiving unit during the analytical transfer should meet appropriate specifications to ensure the requirements of the method or specification are met. That means the equipment used by receiving unit during analytical transfer, it should meet appropriate specifications which ensure requirements of method or specification, they are met. Next one, receiving unit ensure that adequately trained and experienced person are in place for analytical testing. So it ensure adequately trained as well as experienced person that are placed for analytical testing or not. So receiving unit test experienced person. Second one is, provide a documentation system capable of recording receipt and testing of samples to the required specification using approved test methods and of reporting, recording and collecting data and designation of status, approved, reject or quarantine. That means receiving unit provide a documentation system. They are capable of recording receipt as well as they are capable of testing a sample to the required specification using approved test methods and of reporting, recording and collecting the data and designation of status if approved, rejected or quarantined. And last one, they execute transfer protocol. They perform appropriate level of validation to support the implementation of methods and generate and obtain approval of transfer report. The receiving unit, they perform appropriate level of validation to support implementation of methods and it generate and obtain approval of transfer reports. Next one is appropriate training. It should be provided and all training activities and outcomes should be documented. So appropriate training that should be provided as well as all the training activities and outcomes, all are documented in document system and reference to compendial monograph. Examples like International Pharmacopoeia, European Pharmacopoeia, British Pharmacopoeia and United States Pharmacopoeia where available is accepted. Possible experimental design and acceptance criteria for the main analytical testing methods that are shown in Table 1, we will discuss in next slide. So, possible experimental design as well as acceptance criteria for analytical testing methods that are described in Table 1. Note that this table represents high-level guidance to apply the general principle that method transfer should account for the variability and sensitivity of the method and specifications for the quality parameter. That means, note that Table 1, which represent high-level guidance that are apply the general principle that method transfer should account for the variability as well as sensitivity of the method and the specifications for the quality parameters. And alternative procedure and acceptance criteria that may be applied based on science and the characteristic of analytical method and the analyte. So alternative procedure as well as acceptance criteria, it should be applied that is based on science and characteristic of analytical methods as well as analyte. Possible experimental design and acceptance criteria for analytical testing. First one is identity test. For identity test, consideration for transfer. In this, transfer should focus on sample preparation, instruments, data interpretation, and acceptance to include in asset transfer where relevant. That means, for identity test, transfer, it should focus on sample preparation as well as it should focus on instruments and data interpretation and acceptance to include in asset transfer where it is relevant or not. Replication of test. One determination usually sufficient to demonstrate equivalence. So, one determination or one time test that is sufficient to demonstrate equivalence. In setup and acceptance criteria, that is null. Second one is, second test is microbiological testing. In microbiological testing, quality, qualitative and quantitative limit test. First one, consideration for transfer. Execute common on-site validation protocol, rational, method identity, validation parameters, data summary, acceptance criteria, methods of compiling and analyzing data, handling of out-of-specification results, and follow-up requirements. So, in microbiological testing, which execute common on-site validation protocol, as well as they execute rationals, method identity, and validation parameters, data summary, acceptance criteria, methods of compiling and analyzing data, and handling of out-of-specification results, and use same materials, techniques, and inoculum preparation for microbiological testing. Replication of test validation, that is find out by test that is performed in triplicate manner. And setup is use different lots for each validation exercise. So in setup, use different lots for each validation. And in acceptance criteria, qualitative, that means which demonstrate recovery of microorganism, so it should be acceptable. And in quantitative, recovery levels within acceptance limit specified in protocol. So qualitative, that demonstrate recovery of microorganism, while quantitative, they demonstrate recovery levels within acceptance limit that are specified in protocols. The sending unit and receiving unit should execute transfer protocol and jointly prepare a transfer report. So sending unit and receiving unit both are execute transfer protocol and both are jointly prepare transfer report. And the points to be addressed in the analytical methods transfer report are listed in these guidelines. Next one is qualification and validation. General qualification and validation of facilities, equipment, system, and procedures are essential to demonstrate that all critical stages of the transfer project have been completed successfully, enabling the receiving unit to reproduce the product, process, or method routinely to the specifications agreed with sending unit. That means for qualification and validation, qualification and validation of facility, equipment, system, and procedure, all are essential to demonstrate that all critical stages of transfer project that have been completed successfully, enabling the receiving unit to reproduce the product process routinely to the specifications that are agreed with sending unit. That means qualification and validation of facility, equipment, any system or procedure, all are essential to demonstrate that all the critical stages of transfer project, they have been completely successfully enable the receiving unit to reproduce product, process, or methods to the specifications that is agreed with sending unit. Validation performed as a part of transfer project should be documented in a validation master plan. That means validation performed, and that is a part of transfer project, it should be documented in validation master plan. We already discussed what is validation master plan in lecture number 2 and lecture number 3. The validation master plan should identify the stages which need to be validated and define acceptance criteria. So validation master plan, that should identify stages required to be validated as well as they define acceptance criteria. For intra-company transfer, receiving unit should operate under the same validation master plan as the sending unit. That That means, and for intercompany transfer, VMP, that means Validation Master Plan, should be in place at receiving unit before the transfer. That means, for intra-company transfer, receiving unit, it should operate under the same Validation Master Plan as the sending unit, while intercompany transfer Validation Master Plan should be in place at receiving unit before transfer. Next one is receiving unit, it should prepare a validation protocol for each sequential step, and successful execution of each validation protocol should be documented in a validation report. That means receiving unit, it should prepare validation protocol for each step, and successful execution of each validation protocol, it should be documented in validation report. Setting up and commissioning of system at the receiving unit need to be completed before qualification and validation can be performed at the receiving unit. That means setting up as well as commissioning of system at receiving unit, they are need to be completed before qualification as well as validation, they are performed at receiving unit. So setting up and commission of system at receiving unit that are completed before qualification and validation that are performed at receiving unit. The steps required for this purpose have been described in this guideline for buildings, services and equipment, manufacturing, packaging and cleaning in analytical testing. That means steps that are required for this type of purpose that are described in these guidelines for buildings, service, any equipments, manufacturing, packaging, cleaning, and analytical testing. In brief, the following basic steps apply equally to each of these areas. So which type of steps are apply to each of areas? The sending unit should provide information on materials, systems and procedures involved in the manufacturing of the product, process or method to be transferred. And the receiving unit should review the information provided by sending unit and audit its current system, equipment and processes, including non-process related practice, and support services that impact the process. That means sending unit, it should provide information on materials, systems and procedure that are involved in manufacturing of product, process or method to be transferred. That means sending unit provide various information on materials, system as well as procedures that are involved in manufacturing of product, process or method to be transferred. Second one is receiving unit. It should review the information that is provided by sending unit and audits its current system, equipment, processes, including non-process related practices, and with support services that impacts the process. Based on this review, receiving unit should either accept the information provided or develop it further to prepare site-specific procedures, standard operating procedures, training programs, and protocols which will form the basis of the qualification and validation. That means based on review, receiving unit, it should either accept the information that is provided and it further to prepare site-specific procedure, standard operating procedures, training program and protocols which will form the basis of qualifications as well as validations and relevant steps. Example, operators, analyst, all should be trained in any new process if required. Once the required system and procedure have been commissioned at receiving unit and successful training has been documented, qualification and validation of facility and equipment should be executed, followed by validation of analytical test methods, process validation for manufacturing and packaging and cleaning validation. That means once the required system and procedure that have been commissioned at receiving unit and successful training that has been documented, qualification and validation of facility and equipment all should be executed and followed by validation of analytical test method, process validation for manufacturing, packaging and cleaning validation. Next one is qualification of facility and equipment. In this, the receiving unit should review the gap analysis described and prepare, where appropriate, validation protocol for facility, service and equipment. So, receiving unit, they should review gap analysis that are described and prepared, where appropriate, validation protocols for the facilities, services as well as equipments. Next one is both new and existing equipment should satisfy the validation protocols that are associated with purchase and design specification, factory acceptance test if possible, IQ and OQ. That means both new as well as existing equipment, they should satisfy validation protocols that are associated with purchase and design specifications, as well as they are also associated with factory acceptance test, if possible, IQ as well as OQ. We already discussed what is IQ as well as what is OQ. Performance qualification, including a further assessment of operating parameters with relation to product characteristics, should be established on commencement of trial batches. And successful completion of qualification and validation should be documented in a report. That means successful completion of qualification and validation that are included in document form and maintained in report form. Analytical methods validation. In analytical methods validation, validation of analytical methods should address the specificity, linearity of response, range, accuracy, precision, detection limit, quantitation limit, and robustness of analytical test method. So what is analytical methods validation? So validation of analytical method, they should address specificity, linearity of response, range, accuracy, precision, detection limit, quantitation limit, and robustness of analytical test methods. The analytical methods transfer protocol should cover the following sections: objective, scope, responsibility of sending unit as well as receiving unit, materials, methods, equipment, the experimental design and acceptance criteria, and last one is documentation, including information to be supplied with the result and reports form to be used if anyone is present. Next one is deviations, reference, signed approval and details of reference samples like API, intermediate and finished products. And successful transfer and validation of analytical method, they should be documented in a report. So successful transfer and validation of analytical methods that are documented in report. Next one is manufacturing process validation. In manufacturing process validation, based on process information and documentation described, the receiving unit, it should make the preparations to conduct process validation studies to ensure that the manufacturing process and associated testings area executed properly. For this purpose, receiving unit should prepare. That means, based on process information and documentation described, receiving unit, it should make preparation to conduct process validation studies to ensure that the manufacturing process and associated testing, they are executed properly. And for this purpose, receiving unit, it should prepare provisional batch manufacturing document and a process validation protocol based on key steps and parameters is defined in the description of manufacturing process and specifying testing requirements based on the analytical methodology transfer. That means a process validation protocol based on key steps and parameters that are defined in description of manufacturing process. They specify testing requirements based on analytical methodology transfer. Process validation protocol, it should include a short description of process, batch manufacturing record, and key stage of production. So process validation include short or small description of any process, batch manufacturing records, and key stages of production. Finished product specification, analytical methodology, sample plan for intermediate, in-process quality control and acceptance criteria, corrective action and change control, sign off of authorized person, regulatory assessment, and conclusion and recommendation. Upon approval of batch documents, SOPs, test methods, and the validation protocols, and after successful training of operators and analysts, receiving unit should execute process validation study. That means, after approval of batch documents, SOP, test methods, and validation protocols, and after successful training of operators and all analysts, receiving unit, they execute process validation study. While it is useful to have sending unit personnel present to supervise the first batches manufactured, staff from the receiving unit should execute all activities so that the study is representative of manufacturing operations undertaken at the receiving unit. That means, while it is useful to have sending unit personnel present to supervise first batch manufacture as well as staff from receiving unit, it should execute all the activities so that study, it is the representative of manufacturing operations that are undertaken at receiving unit. Statistical optimization of key processing parameters and prospective validation will be undertaken at receiving unit after initial implementation of manufacturing process, and any deviations or incidents should be recorded and reviewed by quality assurance and regulatory affairs personnel, and a change control procedure involved if it is deemed necessary. Successful completion of manufacturing process validation, it should be implemented in document form in a process validation report. In packaging, after reviewing of information provided received from the sending unit, initial qualification of packaging components, the receiving unit should prepare protocol for qualification of packaging equipment, a provisional packaging record protocol, and validation of packaging operations. That means, in packaging, after reviewing of information that is provided and it is received from sending unit, initial qualification of packaging component, the receiving unit, it should prepare protocols for qualification of packaging equipments and provisional packaging record protocol and validation of packaging operations. Critical packaging parameters to be included in the packaging validation protocol and subsequent in-process quality control. Examples like thermosealing temperature for blister pack, accuracy of fill volumes, weight on tablets, seal integrity and torque, correct printing of data like a lot number as well as expiry date, and correct barcode and pharmacode reading, and successful packaging validation that will be included in document form in validation report, which will form part of transfer documentation. Cleaning validation. Cleaning procedure, it should strictly follow validated method. And the objective of cleaning validation, according to their name, cleaning is validated. And it should confirm the reliability of the cleaning procedure so that the analytical monitoring may be omitted or reduced to a minimum in a routine phase. That means objective of cleaning validation is to confirm reliability of cleaning procedure. Therefore, the analytical monitoring, they may be omitted or reduced to a minimum in a routine phase. And normally, only cleaning procedures for product contact surfaces of the equipment need to be validated. And analytical methods for testing of swab or rinse sample, it should be validated before cleaning validation study is carried out. Based on information on limits of product residue transferred from sending unit, the receiving unit should determine its own practical, achievable, and verifiable limits for cleaning validation based on a consideration of the materials involved, their properties, and their therapeutic dose. That means based on information on limits of product residue transfer from sending unit, the receiving unit, it should determine its own practical, achievable, and verifiable limits for cleaning validation that is based on a consideration of materials involved and their properties and their therapeutic doses. At least 3 consecutive application of the cleaning procedure, it should be performed and shown to be successful in order to prove that method is validated. It is usually not considered acceptable to test until clean. That means at least 3 consecutive application of cleaning procedure, it should be performed and show to be successful in order to prove that method is validated, and it is usually not considered acceptable until it is completely clean. The analytical methods should be challenged in combination with the sampling methods used and to demonstrate both the levels of recovery from the equipment surface and reproducibility of result. That means analytical methods, it should be a challenge in combination with sampling methods used, and it demonstrates that both the levels of recovery from equipment surface and reproducibility of results. If any query or doubts related to topic, write your questions in comment box. Thank you.